My experience is both pretty similar to earlier earlier institutions or where I've taught. Similar in the sense that I always confront the same problem, which is that the school system has given you so little knowledge of the roots of the culture, the way, you know, the concept of India evolved, the way one India evolved. That is to say, one India with a lot of diversity, but also lots of mechanisms of integration and unity, etc. So this is one problem which is not personal to you, and it's simply the fact that there's a major flaw in the education system, because we can only benefit from knowing our past objectively, without exaggeration, without glorification. But there's enough in India's past to be quite proud of in terms of accomplishments of civilization, the cities, the trade, the arts, the literature, the philosophy. So there's quite a bit, the architecture and so on. This group has certainly been different. It has been different for two reasons. First of all, it's a very heteroclite group. It's not very homogeneous. You are not all BTECs, you are not all MBAs. So that, of course, enriches the dialogue. So you're not hunting for a degree, you're not trying to get a credit at any cost. So in that sense, this is a more open group, perhaps. You've also had a lot of exposure to many different people and many different topics. So clearly that creates a certain openness in the mind. So I think that this has been mutually enriching. I think this fellowship program is a brilliant concept, and I hope you will, I'm sure you will all have immensely benefited from it.